COVID-19 changed our ways of life, ways of communication, and ways of work. So I made a trip to China early this year and was quarantined in a hotel room for 3 weeks. I thought this is gonna be really hard. Imagine that, like staying in a single room and meeting no one for such a long time, right? Actually, it turned out not bad. So I ordered food from different restaurants online, okay? So every day, the most exciting moment for me actually was to open the food box and check out the new food I ordered. And also, I could have conference meetings every day with our colleagues and also investors. So the amazing thing was I closed a state round, just a meeting with like friends and potential investors online with Zoom. So many of our investors actually never met me in person before they wrote a check like up to $1 million to me. And also entertainment, right? That's important. That's really important. So I don't have to go to theaters or like to cinemas to watch movies. What I need was like TikTok, right? I spend hours and hours watching short videos at TikTok. And also I can watch movies and TV shows at YouTube or like Netflix and music. Music, that's part of my life, actually. So I don't have to go to CD stores to buy CDs, right? I don't even have to download anything. I just open my iPhone and use my Apple Music. All I need is just my iPhone and the internet. I think that's quite efficient for me. It seems like the internet had changed a lot of our lives and also brought us together during the hard time of pandemic. The things like, is the internet good enough? In my opinion, it's not. The internet is not the perfect solution for the future life. So why? Let's take a look at the music industry, the industry that has been changed profoundly by internet. So as I mentioned that nowadays, most people won't go to a CD store to buy CDs, right? They don't even download music as we did before, right? We tend to just play the music at some like platform, a streaming platform. The music seems to be more accessible than before. But the life of the musicians is not getting better. It's not getting easier. Instead, it's getting more difficult for them. This is really bad. So why is this happening? Imagine in the old days, the musicians just to sell their CDs to the fans. If you want to make a decent life, that's easy. You can just sell like probably like 10,000 or 100,000 copies of your CDs. That's good enough. That's good enough to have a decent life with this business model. But nowadays, the Spotify, the Apple Music, and other streaming platforms actually take the majority of the market. And at this platform, the musicians can only get like less than 1 cent per stream. So if they want to make a decent life, they actually have to sell their music to the fans at like more than tens of millions times per year. And we did a calculation. So for the Spotify, musicians, if they want to make a minimum wage in the US, they have to make their music be played by the fans at the platform at least 3.5 million times per year. And at YouTube Music, the number will up to 19 million times. That's a lot. That's unlikely for many musicians to achieve the goal, right? This is even worse in China. Actually, I met a friend working in an internet company in China, and he told me that for every 10 million times played on their platform, can only generate like 1,000 or to 1,500 US dollars for the musicians. That's tough. That's really tough. And also for the around 50% of the Chinese musicians can only collect probably like $300 per month from the platform play their music. This is not right, right? Because the music they made for us, beautiful. But they can only get such little money out of this. This is not fair. So another thing is like, for every $1 we spent on the music, only 15 cents will go to the pocket of the musicians. 85% of the revenue actually goes to like the producers, the labels, the sales channels, the collecting agencies. I think this is sick. This is not right. Because it's not middlemen make these beautiful arts, right? We should reward the musicians, the content creators, instead of the middlemen. As a consumer, we just need one click, 1 second, to enjoy the music or the online content. But for the content creators, it sometimes spends them like several weeks, several months, even a couple of years to receive the payments. The delayed payments make it really, really hard for them to have a sustainable life. The most unfair stuff in this industry is the middleman fee. So the legal structure for music copyright is complex. So it's really difficult for the agencies to identify the real owner of the copyright. So sometimes in the industry, up to 20% to 50% of the copyright revenue actually never reach to the content owners, the real copyright owners. So what happens to this part of revenue? They were used as an administration fee for the agencies or just distributed among other members of the society. So what can we do? How can we fix this? I believe that blockchain provides us a solution. So let's imagine. If we can allow the copyright owners or the musicians or the content creators to issue NFT, non-fungible tokens, and tokenize their copyright of the content and sell this content directly to the market, to the investors, to the fans, there will be no middlemen, right? They will control 100% of their revenue, their copyright, instead of like just a little portion of that. Another thing is the delay payment. So since blockchain is actually a smart contract which can be self-enforced, there will be no lawyers. There will be no collecting agencies to go after each of the users, right, and collect the money back. There will be no delay payment. They don't have to wait. They can receive the royalties at the same second of the users play that. Another thing is blockchain is transparent. Everyone will know the transactions and also knows the details of the ownership. It's very easy for the owners, content owners, to track. Okay, so who is the co-owners? Who should have a part of this copyright? And what's the portion of that? And how should we distribute among us, right? There will be no collecting agencies, and there will be no waste, no black box into this. So what about the fans? So we can design a token economy to encourage the fans participate in this industry as an investor or like a producer. So imagine that as a fan, you will be able to support the musicians you like directly. And also you can purchase part of his work. You can be owner of the work you like. And also there will be some GameFi stuff playing here. You can earn by listening to the music. You can also earn some money by promoting the music you love. you can share the music with your friends, and also together you can make some money together. So in this way, everyone in this industry, everyone in this value chain can receive their money because of their contribution to this value chain and also because of their contribution to this market. No one will be ignored by this system, right? Because this is no longer a centralized market. It's like now decentralized market, and everyone is equal in this market. I believe that the current industry needs a revolution. The current internet needs a revolution. Let's embrace the blockchain and make this happen. Let's rebuild this industry and rebuild our life together. Thanks.